not super well endowed, don't worry, with these positions, she can still feel like a porn star. The average joystick length is 5.16 inches, that is between 4 to 6 inches when erect. If your joystick falls short of that benchmark, then you are statistically on the smaller than average side. For most people, it is not a deal breaker. In fact, studies have shown that women do not really care about size. To quote the old adage, it is not the size of the wave, but the motion of the ocean that matters. And if you know the best knacking positions for guys with smaller joystick, you will be in really good shape. Nonetheless, if you have a smaller than average joystick, you still might feel very insecure about it. Some men made the mistakes of comparing themselves to porn stars, the Olympic athletes of knacking, and that isn't just realistic. Most women do not talk about wanting a man with a big joystick. They talk about wanting a man who is good in bed. That means someone who is communicative, takes his time, and is attentive to her needs. What more, if you know how to work it, you can use your smaller joystick to your own advantage. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Gracious Choma, your favorite sex coach. So today we're going to be talking about positions that would help those that think that they are on the smaller size. Because I think that if you are on the smaller size, like, I don't even know how many people are on the smaller size actually. There are very few of them. But some people are on the average size side, right? And they feel like they are on the smaller side. And funny enough, women do not even worry about your size. That is the real thing. There are very few people who really think about size. Very few of them. And before we jump into this topic, I need to tell you that your confidence is very important. So you need to feel confident in yourself. And another thing, I think you should try out a partner who appreciates you for whom you are, who actually do not care about size. So many women don't care about size, so you shouldn't worry about that. Then you should worry about your immune system, your technique. It is what you use your size to do that matters. Now I'm going to help you with positions that is going to help you, that is going to be top-notch, that is going to help you hit that G-spot, that is going to help you touch that clit. It is going to help change the game for you and your partner. If you happen to be a little less than well endowed, here are 6 knacking positions to get the most bang for your buck. Porn, very much intended, and moves that will maximize your pleasure. So as usual, I'm going to be showing you a demo of what I mean, but the demo that I'm going to be doing is literally how the lady is going to stay. Now, even the positions I'm going to give you, I'm going to be talking to the ladies, right? So this is how you ladies are going to stay. And then your partner is going to be grinding from the position that you stay. Because literally, the girls are the ones that stay in the position. Then the guy can now enter from the position the girl has portrayed. So whatever position I'm giving you and explaining how you're going to stay, I'm talking to the ladies. They are going to stay like that. So if a guy watching this video, because definitely this video is literally for guys, then you understand how your partner is going to stay. So you'll be able to explain to her, this is how you stay, and then I grind you from here or from there. Number one, get on top and grind. Now I'm talking to the ladies. They are the ones that will get on top and grind. Literally, most times guys worry about size. It is because they want to satisfy their partner most often, right? The lady that really wants to get the best out of that size is going to also help put in some work. Now let me teach you what you're going to do and how you're going to stay. Porn stars usually bust out a thrusting or pounding motion, but I would suggest grind instead. This works well with the vulva owning partner on top, face to face with the joystick owning partner. What you're going to do, bring your body closely together so that they aren't too perpendicular. A smaller joystick may slip out if you aren't close enough. Vulva owning partner can get comfortable, position their pelvis on the joystick, and grind their body against it. Move your hips back and forth, or even try some spirals. Not only will grinding hit the external hot spot of the kitty, but it should benefit your partner's pleasure as well, because the head of the joystick has the most nerve endings. It will get plenty of actions even with the adjusted position. Putting a pillow under your hips for a bit of extra lift. Now I'm talking to the guys, which can offer a feeling of deeper penetration to the vulva owning partner. You can also spread your butt cheek during the ride to engage even more nerve endings and sensations. The second position would be bringing your knees to your chest. Now the ladies, bring your knees to your chest. Lying on your back with your legs wide open, pulling your knees towards your chest. Your partner can then kneel in front of you and then enter you from above. This position allows for a direct approach to penetration. Plus, it leaves room for clitoral stimulation. If your partner holds your thighs in place, you can add a clit vibe to penetration. Number three, do this twist on doggy style. You probably already know that doggy style lends itself to deeper penetration. If your partner has a smaller joystick, you can get a greater sense of fullness by altering this position and lying flat while bringing your legs together. You can grab your favorite vibrator and stick it between your legs under your body, so you're riding it while your partner is riding you. If you're a fan of a lot of friction, this move can set you up to achieve an orgasm fast. Number four, try missionary with one leg up or even two. Lying on your back with one or both legs on your partner's shoulders. By getting your leg or your legs out of the way, you will set the stage for deeper penetration. This is a super romantic position that allows for eye gaze and passionate kiss. You can also add height to the hips with a cushion or pillow to bring you even closer to your partner. Number five, go for a reverse ride. While your partner lies on their back, you can slide onto the joystick while facing their feet. If you bring your legs closer together, you will have more control over the depth of penetration. This position is visually appealing to men and allows for the woman to have easier access to stimulate her clit for heightened pleasure. Your partner can also place a cushion at their back to create a tilt and lift up their pelvis, which results in a greater feeling of fullness. Number six, go for a shoulder holder. Consider this one next level missionary. Instead of having your legs spread apart, put over your partner's shoulders. They can lean into your body for great depth or hold onto your ankles for more support. Bottom line, no matter how you and your partner are getting it on, you would want to prioritize comfort, control, and creativity. Now I call it three C's. Comfort, because if you are preoccupied with pain or fear of pain, it is difficult to focus on pleasure. Control, because great knacking is intentional. And having the ability to add a hand or a toy in the mix can make all the difference. And creativity, because the brain feels exciting when something feels new. But when it comes to pinpointing the ultimate position that checks all these boxes, there really is no such thing as one size fits all. The last thing that I'll tell you is, finding your go-to, hottest, most pleasurable position is always going to be a matter of exploration and experimentation to see what works best for you. So I'm hoping that you got my points and the positions with the demo, you understand my explanation, and if you should take these positions, if you feel that you are on the smaller to average size, these positions or this strategy or these moves is definitely going to help change the knacking game for you and your partner. I'm still your favorite sex coach, Gracious Choma. If you find this video helpful, do not forget to hit that like button. Subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell. Leave a comment down there below on my comment section. I'm going to see you in my next video.